School Cambodia greetings and hello to all of my students at eSchool Cambodia. And this is teacher Charles McCall, Mr. Charles McCall, that is coming to you again. And we're studying New Interchange English, which is English American style, book one. And we're on page 3, unit 1. And in this section of unit 1 on page 3, please take a moment, open your books, and look at exercise number 3. I'd like to remind you, please get the book. You must have the book. So easy. eSchool Cambodia gives you the book for free. You can download it from the eSchool Cambodia app into your phone. Take your phone to a photocopy shop. Download it to your computer. If you don't have a computer, download it to your friend's computer. Take the disc. Take the memory card to the photocopy shop, and they will print it for you. The cost is less than 10,000 riel. And you have the book to be a resource. For me, I know Cambodians don't like to write in their book, but I write in my book. I write everywhere in my book to remind myself. And so when I teach, my notes are already in my book. It's very easy. And I have other notes. I write other notes as well. But you get the book. Please get the book. And so exercise number 3, names and titles. We want to talk a little bit about formal and informal conversation. Formal conversation, formal, F-O-R-M-A-L, formal conversation is when you use the appropriate words to speak to someone. So this is formal. So that is formal, we call it formal words or formal language. You know it. In Cambodia, it's the same way. There's certain words you use when you talk to adults, certain words you use when you talk to people who have honor or have authority, and then there are other words you use when you talk to your friends. And so that's what formal and informal. Formal is words for their position. Informal is and so we want to just talk a little bit about names and titles in this short lesson. And so exercise 3, letter A, use a title with a last name to address someone formally. So we use a title. Mr. is a title. Teacher is a title. President is a title. Lopratian is a title. And so you use a title, and in American English, you use the last name. Yung anaw pisa America, na pisa ang laybay America, yung atdal ta Mr. Charles Day. No, never, ever. Yung ta Mr. McCall. Yung chak ta pra chmua trakul. We fuse the last name. So we say Mr. McCall. I'd like to, as you will see, I would like to introduce you to my father. His name is Mr. Smith. I'd like to introduce you to my coach. my teacher, and his name is Mr. Anglin or Mr. McCool or Mr. something else. We say Mr. or Mrs. You'll see this in a moment. So we use a title with the last name to address someone formally. Look in the picture. Amy, this is my father. Hello, Mr. Mandel. Kwanhatachia, Mr. Mandel. Kwanhatapa. Hello, Dad. Hello, Richard. No, he doesn't call him. She's showing respect to the father. And so she calls him, hello, Mr. Mandel. You look below, use a first name or a nickname without a title to address someone informally. I want to mention address. Address, address, and address. Kokinia, address, kuchia saitan. What is your address? Banpai, napilyan ni ye, by ni, chia address, minita, chia, minita, ni ye taokan, ni ye taokan, when we address. So, if you example, right now, I am addressing e-school Cambodia students. I am addressing. Tomorrow, I will address the e-school Cambodia students. Mình đã kinh nghiệm là nhị yê ta can Chrome mới. Thông ra yếm pra smart Chrome. So tomorrow I will be talking to, I will be speaking to e-school Cambodia students. But we say again formal. The formal word is address. Address, address, asaitan, address. Yay. Spell the same but pronounced different and different meanings. That is English. The English language can be difficult. And so use a first name or nickname without a title to address someone informally. You say this after me. Formal, informal. Formal, informal are adjectives. They describe the noun. Formally, informally, somebody age and we can formally, informally, which is an adverb that describes the adjective or the noun. So formal language, informal language. Say it after me. Formal language, informal language. Formally, 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 informally, formally, formally, informally, formal, informal. So that might be some new words for you. So if you look, they say, this is Chuck. They do not say, this is Mr. Mandel. He said, this is Chuck. This is my friend, Chuck. Chang, I say Charles Chang. This is my friend, Chuck. Oh, hi, Chuck. She does not say, oh, look, Charles, look, Chang, mente. So they're friends. So the first picture is formal language, formal conversation, and the bottom image is informal conversation. And so we have titles for men and we have titles for women. And I know you know that, but let's review. Male, kuchia manuh pro. Female, kuchia manuh srei. You know that. Male and female. Man and woman, boy and girl. And so the title, a title for a man, if he is married or if he is single, nuikinia, Mr. If you look on the slide, capital M, small r, period. And we pronounce it Mr. Mr. If he is married or if he is single. For a female, if she is married or if she is single, we can call her Ms. Ms. Big M, small s, period, but we do not pronounce it miss. The S has the Z sound, Ms. We call them Ms. By yung at dang da kwat rip ka ur ka na li yung hata Ms. By yung at dang chma yung hata Ms. Chia som rom sabak kur pevli ba kwat rip ka ur ka man rip ka by yung at dang. Sabrap kanya, sabrap a single girl, we call her Miss. You know that. Miss. And for a married woman, we can call her Ms. But usually, piet da som rom ku Mrs. Capital M, small r, small s, period, and we say it Mrs. And so Mr., Ms., Miss, and Mrs. And so those are the titles for men or women. I'm going to read you a conversation and you listen. This is your listening skills. And so I'm going to read you a conversation and you tell me, is it formal or is it informal? Okay, I will read each sentence. There are six sentences. I will read each sentence twice, then you tell me if it's formal or if it's informal by the words that I use, okay? Listen, number one, good afternoon, Mr. Chang. Please sit down. Good afternoon, Mr. Chang. Please sit down. Is that formal or is it informal? It's formal because they call him Mr. Chang is the formal language. Number two, hello Chuck, nice to see you. Hello Chuck, nice to see you. Is that informal or is it formal? It's informal because he calls him by his nickname, like a friend. Number three, hi Liz, how are you? Hi Liz, how are you? Is that formal or is it informal? It's informal because she calls her by her nickname like she's talking to a friend. Number four, it's nice to meet you, Ms. Mendel. It's nice to meet you, Ms. Mendel. Is that formal or informal? It's formal because she uses the title, Ms. Mendel. Not like she's talking to a friend, but she's talking to someone she wants to show respect. Number five, pleased to meet you, Ms. Kim. Pleased to meet you, Ms. Kim. Formal or informal? It's formal because she uses the title, Ms. Kim. And number six, oh, hi, Amy, I'm fine. Oh, hi, Amy, I'm fine. Is that formal or informal? Of course, it's informal. Amy, short for Amelia, and nickname for Amelia, and she's talking to her like a friend. Very good, you got them all right. Number one, Lake Moy in my class. And so I'm going to read these. You'll see them on your screen. I'm going to read them and you practice saying them after me. Good afternoon, Mr. Chang. Please sit down. Hello, Chuck. Nice to see you. Hi, Liz. How are you? It's nice to meet you, Ms. Mendel. Pleased to meet you, Ms. Kim. Oh, hi, Amy. I'm fine. All right, so that's the short lesson for today. We're learning about titles, and we're learning about informal conversation and formal conversation. You're number one. You're my great students, and I will see you again in our next lesson.